Let's talk investing. Our next guest says there's a reason mining stocks are amongst the most volatile investments out there, but he says they may be poised for a big payoff. Louis James is here to help investors make the most out of mining stocks. He's Senior Metal Investment Strategist at KC Research. And morning, Louis.
Morning.
You know, you look at the materials, and even today we're looking at the Toronto Stock Exchange down while the Dow is hitting records. Why is there so much pressure on materials right now?
Well, it's interesting. You'd think if business is booming and there's a reason, good reason, for the Dow to be hitting new records, well, that should be good for commodities. That should be good for metals, which are required for business. So there's a disconnect here.
Okay. Why the disconnect, though? Are people not investing in these stocks because they prefer something else, or are they investing in the underlying commodities? What's the deal?
Well, that's a rhetorical pause. I mean, do we really have a real recovery is the question, or is it government money printing that's causing an inflation in stock prices? I suspect you know what my answer is to that, and I don't need to spoon feed it to your listeners. I mean, just look at what's going on. The Nikkei's up all of a sudden. It's not rocket science. They're going to print a bunch of money. Everybody knows where it's going to go, and you can see the immediate consequences for their stock market. And when we talk about a jobless recovery in the U.S., and I know that recently the unemployment statistics have looked a little more favorable, but the reality is you look around the U.S., and it's not a booming job market. You talk about a jobless recovery, and that's really not a recovery at all. What we have is an artificially created situation where the government is admittedly pumping billions of dollars into the economy every month, new dollars every month, and that has an impact. And those dollars need to go somewhere, and a lot of them are going into equities right now, general equities. And that is disconnected from the fundamental underlying realities of the marketplace. So that's the bad news. You know, money is acting under constraints shaped by government policy instead of economic reality.
Yeah, I agree with you, Lou, and a lot of this. I mean, you can make the argument that in the case of Japan, for instance, you're going to have a lower currency, and that should boost exports, and that's good for people around the world, or the Japanese at least, to sell those things. But when they make those investments, they got to buy metals to make the cars or whatever it is that they're exporting. So the argument is well down the road, and yet we're not seeing the metal prices reflect that, or the stocks in particular. Why?
Right. Well, so again, you have money chasing the path of least resistance. That's not the same as actual real growth. There's a lot of cause for concern. You've got the EU on the verge of disintegration. They're China's number one customer, so you've got to worry about Asian production if you think that the Chinese or India is going to save us all. But their customers are going away. There's a lot of cause for concern. So if you're a businessman that's thinking of expanding, say, an auto manufacturing business or a smelter that's going to produce more iron or copper or whatever, you're looking at the economic realities. You're looking at orders from customers. You're not looking at what the stock market is doing necessarily to tell you what to do.
Yeah, in addition, I think, Louis, consideration has to be given to the cost of mining as well, because that seems to be going up as governments, there's regulations you have to get through, foreign governments you have to deal with on a regular basis, and your costs, your input costs are going up as well.
Right. Now, that can almost be a rosy glasses for us, because, you know, as people into the mining sector, we want to look for positive things, and that's absolutely true. We call it supply destruction, right? Nobody wants a mine in their backyard. It's a very NIMBY sensitive thing, and it doesn't have to be uranium or anything scary, even something as benign as copper or zinc. You know, who's scared of zinc? Nobody's scared of zinc. But nobody wants a mine in their backyard. It's increasingly unwelcome everywhere in the world. And where it is welcome, they're taking more and more out at the tax level or the royalty level or what have you. It's getting more expensive, more difficult everywhere in the world. And that supply constraint, at the end of the day, will be the driver. The end of the day could be quite a while from now. In the meantime, you've got all kinds of interventions, manipulations, speculations going on in the marketplace. So as we started out with, you know, these can be the most volatile stocks on earth.
Would you buy, Louis, right now, some of these mining stocks in anticipation of a couple of years down the road?
I would, and I would by sector, I guess. One of the things that I think is a particular opportunity right now is the gold sector. If you look at the long-term gold chart, the 10-year chart, for example, it very much looks like a wave that's crested. You know, you had a long, long rise for many, many years, And the last couple of years, it's gone sideways, or maybe tipped over a little bit if you count the 1900 peak in 2011. And I think that's really put a profoundly bearish sentiment into the gold market space. And of course, a bear market is a shopper's market. When you have a bear market sentiment out there, you have more sellers than buyers, and that's good for the buyers. But that's only a good thing if you think the market's going to recover. If you don't think it's actually peak, but it's in a correction, then the correction is a buying opportunity. So what are the fundamentals? I think I always want to look at fundamentals over the charts. A chart can only tell you for sure what has been. It cannot prove anything about where things are going. So yes, if you look at the charts, the long-term charts, it looks like we may have had a peak. If you look at the 200-day moving averages, they've curved over. It is kind of frightening, but it is backward-looking, and it doesn't address the fundamentals. And the fundamentals are what we were just talking about, government money getting run amok all over the place, and that has to show up in the price of gold. The fundamentals are extremely bullish, and that makes this correction a buying opportunity.
Louis, great to chat. Thank you. Louis James, Senior Metals Investment Strategist at Casey Research. To find out more, visit downturn.caseyresearch.com.